Hello viewers, I would like to welcome you to this very special interview with the one and only civil rights leader, Martin Luther King Jr., who will be looking briefly at his life. Martin, welcome.
Thank you.
Born in Atlanta, Georgia in 1929 to your mother, a school teacher, and your father, a Baptist minister.
All correct.
Call you Martin now, but you weren't called Michael before. You were called Michael before.
Yes, I used to be called Michael years ago, when I was a little boy, because my parents changed it.
So Martin, if I can call you Martin.
Oh yes, of course you can.
Martin, you must be widely recognised for your I Have a Dream speech.
Yes, I can remember that quite clearly.
Do you?
Yes, I do. It was Wednesday, the 28th of August, 1963. I was in front of 200,000 or so civil rights supporters on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial.
It was during the March on Washington for
Jobs and Freedom.
Yes, the March on Washington for Jobs and Freedom.
It was organised by Bayard Rustin and Cleveland Robinson.
That was quite scary, I guess.
You betcha. I nearly chickened out, but it had to be done, so I plucked up the courage and did it for 17 minutes.
Yes. Well, good on you. Now that march is credited greatly in helping passing the Civil Rights Act of 1964 and the Voting Rights Act of 1965.
Black people such as I deserve the right to be equal.
Yes, they do. And you do.
Thank you.
No problem. Now moving on and moving back to your early life. You entered Morehouse College in 1944. You then went to Crozer Religious Seminary to undertake your postgraduate studies, and then you received a doctorate in, when was it?
In 1955.
Then after that, I believe, you returned to the South where you were born, didn't you?
Yes, I returned to the South and became a pastor of a Baptist church in Montgomery, Alabama.
Days.
Mm-hmm. And you first achieved national renown when you helped out in the Montgomery bus boycott that lasted for
382 days it lasted, and it led to bus companies changing their rules and regulations.
The odd days. And I believe the Supreme Court declared that this segregation was unconstitutional.
Yes, it all started off thanks to Rosa Parks.
Your mate, Rosa Parks.
Yeah, because she refused to give up her seat, which I think was very brave of her.
It was, wasn't it?
Yes, quite.
Now, after that, you became part of the SCLC.
The Southern Leadership Christian Conference.
And it was founded to help organise protests against discrimination.
Yes.
And I hear that you supported Gandhi's non-violent methods of protest against the British rule in India.
Culminating in India's independence in 1947.
Exactly. Then in 1961 you contributed in the Albany movement, and in 1963 you led protests against discrimination in Birmingham, Alabama, in which white people were resisting desegregation violently.
Yes, they were. The place, Birmingham, was nicknamed Birmingham. In fact, as the attacking and protesting
increased.
Unfortunately, I was arrested and jailed shortly after my participation.
Yes, you were, weren't
you? Unfortunately, yeah.
You. But that then led to the March on Washington, where you delivered your I Have a Dream speech.
Yes.
Then you contributed in the protests in St. Augustine in Florida and Selma in Alabama, where I believe you joined forces with the SNCC.
Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee.
Precisely, and that was in December of 1964.
Committee. The SNCC had been working on registration for voters for several months.
You then earned the Nobel Prize, the Peace Prize, the next year.
1964.
Then there was the Selma to Montgomery marches in 1965, moving on to Chicago in 1966, where it became quite violent, and I hear that you got hit by a brick.
64. Yes, especially the march to Marquette Park on 5th of August 1966, where bottles were thrown and people were screaming.
Oh?
I also received death threats and, after being hit by a brick, I carried on despite the danger.
Good on you. In 1965, you also led a campaign to let you and your fellow black people vote. Following that, as I explained earlier, Congress passed the Voting Rights Act,
letting us in the South vote.
After that, you continued.
I'm such a worker, aren't I?
You sure are. What was I just talking about now? I can't remember now.
Oh yes,
You continued on.
I did.
Continued on. You protested against the Vietnam War in 1965 and the levels of poverty in the U.S. in 1968.
The Poor People's Campaign.
Now on to the next subject, conspiracies.
Campaign. Okay.
About affairs and stuff.
Well, they are all untrue.
As I expected.
True. All untrue.
Well, at least we got that cleared up.
Yeah.
Moving on to a nicer subject, I hear that there are talks.
Yeah. Talks?
Talks about a national holiday in your name, to be celebrated on the third Monday of January.
Oh, really?
January. Well, aren't there?
Really? We'll just have to see about that, won't we?
Oh, I see.
I can't reveal anything. You'll just have to see.
Oh, okay.
See. There may or may not be.
Okay. Alright, well anyway, it seems that we have run out of time.
Oh no!
It's been nice speaking to you on this, on this fine day.
It has been a pleasure.
Thank you very much for coming in today.
Sure. Not at all.
And thank you viewers for watching. Depending on what time in which you are watching this, I wish you a pleasant morning, afternoon or evening. Goodbye.